Good morning, class 9. Welcome to the bio class. As you all know that we have started with the chapter tissues and we have discussed what is a tissue. Tissue is a group of cells performing a common function. Now children, after tissues, I have started with the plant tissues and I have told you that plant tissues are of two types. The first one was the meristematic tissue. Meristematic means they are the actively dividing tissues, means the cells of the meristematic tissue have the capacity to divide. And the second one was the permanent tissues. Permanent tissues means they have lost their ability to divide. Now children, meristematic tissues on the basis of their location can be divided into three parts. Those were apical meristem, the second one was intercalary meristem, and the third one was the lateral meristem. Now coming back to the permanent tissues, in permanent tissues I have classified them into two parts. The first one was the simple permanent tissues. Now simple permanent tissues means they are made up of only one type of cell, made up of similar type of cells. Now this simple permanent tissues, the detailed explanation we have done means you have studied about the protective tissue, the supportive tissue. The supportive tissues were the parenchyma, collenchyma and the sclerenchyma. Now complex permanent tissues means they are made up of more than one type of cell. Means they are made up of different cells, but together they perform a common function. Together these cells perform a common function. Now children, let's move on to the detailed explanation of the complex permanent tissues. Now the complex permanent tissue in plant is the conducting tissue or the vascular tissue. It is of two types, xylem and phloem. Xylem is responsible for the conduction of water and minerals in plants, whereas the phloem is responsible for the conduction of food. Now children, suppose this is the soil surface. Now below the soil surface, roots are present. So these roots are responsible for the absorption of water and minerals from the soil. As the water and minerals will be absorbed by the root hairs, the xylem tissue present in the roots will conduct the water and minerals to the xylem present in the stem. So the conduction of water and minerals will occur in the upward direction against the gravity. Now children, in xylem, the water is conducted only in one direction, that is upward direction against the gravity. But what about phloem? Phloem is the food transporting tissue, and you all know that the green parts of the plant is responsible for performing the process of photosynthesis. So the food has to be transported to every cell of the plant, whether present below the leaf or whether present in the upward direction. This means that food gets transported in both the directions, upward and downward, whereas the water is conducted only in the upward direction. Now children, let's begin with a detailed explanation of xylem. Now xylem tissues has four types of cells in it. Now these cells, xylem cells, are thick-walled and elongated. Now thick-walled means they have a deposition of a waterproof material, and that waterproof material is called as lignin. Lignin provides a mechanical support to the cells. Now the xylem cells are in the form of tubular passage so that the water and minerals can pass through it. It conducts water and minerals absorbed by the root in the upward direction. Now children, older xylem forms the wood and does not participate in the water conduction. The age of a tree can be determined by counting the number of annual rings, which are also called as the xylem rings. Children, you can see here that these rings are present, very fine lines are present. These rings are called as the annual rings. Actually, these are the xylem rings. Now, these xylem rings can be counted, and we can determine the age of a tree after counting the numbers. Suppose it has 15 rings and the age of the tree will be 15 years. So children, let's move on to the cells, the types of cells present in the xylem tissue. It is of the four types of cells are present. The first one is the xylem vessels. The second one is the xylem tracheids. The third one is the xylem parenchyma. And the fourth one is the xylem fibers. Now children, vessels. Vessels are made up of more than one cell. See here, suppose this is a cell. Then this one is the second cell. This one is the third cell. Like this, many cells are present one above the other, and the transverse wall present in between the cells is dissolved so that they form a continuous channel so that water and minerals can be conducted. Now you can see here, these the center one. This one is a xylem vessel. And the next one is the xylem tracheids. Tracheids are spindle-shaped cells. But the difference between the xylem vessel and the xylem tracheids is that xylem vessels are made up of more than one cells, but xylem tracheids are single cell. You can take a look here. Suppose this is a xylem tracheid. This is a single cell, a tracheid. This one is the next one. Now, how the water is conduction occurs through the tracheids. Suppose this is the third one. So the water is passed from here, and through the pits it goes to this cell, and from the pits again it moves to this cell. This is how the water is conducted through the tracheids. The third one is the xylem parenchyma. Now xylem parenchyma is responsible for the storage of food. Along with that, it also helps in the sideways conduction of water. And the xylem fibers, the last one, is responsible for providing the mechanical support to the tissue. Now take a look here, children. These are the vessels. This one is the vessel. This one is the tracheid. This one is the fiber. And these are the parenchyma cells present in the xylem tissue. Now let's go through the detailed explanation of each and every cell. Let's start with xylem vessels. Xylem vessels are long tube-like structures made up of elongated cells placed end-to-end, as I have shown you. Suppose this is a cell. Again, I am telling you, this is the second cell. It means these are placed end-to-end. Cell walls are hard, thick, and lignified. Again, lignified means deposition of lignin occurs in the cell wall, making the surface hard and rigid. Lignin, L-I-G-N-I-N. This lignin is a waterproof material. Now the next one is the transverse wall get dissolved and make a continuous water pipe, as it is shown in this diagram. Now let's move on to the xylem tracheids. Xylem tracheids are elongated dead cells. Now children, remember, in xylem, only xylem parenchyma is the living one. Remaining are the dead ones. Elongated dead cells with large cavities without any content. Cells are placed end to end, forming a long tube, as it is shown here. You can take a look again. Then highly lignified cell walls provide mechanical support by developing various types of thickenings in their walls. Now, what do you understand by the developing various types of thickenings in their walls? Thickening means deposition of lignin, and various types means this lignin is deposited in various manner in the wall of the tracheids. That's why we say that by developing various types of thickenings in their walls. Now, the next one is the xylem parenchyma. Xylem parenchyma is the living parenchyma cells associated with the xylem. They serve for the storage of food, and they also help in the transportation of water and minerals. Now, the last one is the xylem fibers. Xylem fibers provides mechanical support to the xylem tissue. Now, children, that's all about xylem. In the next video, I will explain you about phloem. Children, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you. That's all for today.